I've said it in previous videos, and I stand by it. Improving your drawing skills will absolutely improve your painting skills, and vice versa. They go hand in hand. But the only way you're going to improve is if you practice. There are a number of ways that you can transfer an image onto your painting surface. I've covered some of those methods on this channel in previous videos. This time I'm working on a pair of shoes, and the image that I need to transfer is this one. Now, this particular project is a gift for my daughter. Christmas is right around the corner, and I hope she doesn't watch this before then, but we'll see. This was a little bit risky. She is a huge Marvel fan. Her favorite characters are Iron Man and Spider-Man. So I decided to paint a custom pair of shoes for her. Iron Man on one shoe and Spider-Man will be on the other. The easiest method to probably transfer this design onto a shoe would be to cut out a paper mask and transfer it that way. But I think I can probably sketch it out faster than I could actually cut out a paper mask, so I'm just gonna sketch it. And it gives me a good excuse to put this little video together showing you guys a quick tip for making sure you keep your proportion correct. What I started with is I took a piece of tracing paper and I traced around one side of the shoe to give me a rough idea of the actual size of these shoes. And then I scanned that into the computer so I had a digital copy. And then I took the image of Iron Man and sized it accordingly. So now I have a printout of the image that is sized exactly how I want it to look on the shoe. What I'm about to show you works when you are using a reference image that is sized exactly to the size that you want your project to be. So let's go to the drawing table. I'll demonstrate what I'm talking about on this printout first, simply because I think it will be easier for you guys to see what I'm actually doing on the paper as compared to the shoe itself. I don't use the traditional method that you will see in drawing books and things where if you are going to draw a human face, how you start with the oval and then you draw the center like that. I just draw what I see, mainly because drawing your center lines in there actually gives you more things to erase, and I really don't want to have to erase anything if I don't have to, especially on a shoe. So I just start by drawing exactly what I see. So his head is roughly an oval. Now, in order to check proportion, to make sure that I'm on the right track, I like to use a clear plastic ruler. So I can take the reference image and measure the width of his head, which is about just over an inch and a quarter, about 5/16, and then I can check my actual drawing to see if I'm on target. And that's pretty close to an inch and 5/16. Same thing with how tall his head is. The chin comes down to, it may be hard to see in the video because it's kind of a crappy printout, but it's right at about 2 inches. And my drawing is a little bit shy of that, so I could always bring the jaw down just a little bit farther. So that right there would pretty much be where the gold part separates the red part at the bottom. This is mouth. Same for the eyes. We can check to see how far down the eyes are from the top of the head, which is about an inch and 3/16. My eye is a little bit high there. It needs to come down to about right there. Same thing for the little mouth slit. We can see how far that is from about the center of the eyes, or let's go to the bottom of the eye. It's right about a half an inch, and I am right about a half an inch, so that's pretty good. And that's essentially how I use a ruler, just to double check my proportions to make sure everything is at least pretty close to the reference. Proportion is one of those things that we all make mistakes on. I am a pretty seasoned artist, and I still have to go back and check my work and make corrections all of the time. It's okay, it happens. Your eyes will deceive you. You'll see when I actually sketch this onto the shoe that I get the eyes too high again the first time that I sketch them out on the shoe. It's not a big deal. Correct it and rock on. In this particular example, I'm not going for 100% accuracy. This is going onto a shoe, it's a very small scale, and it's a fictional character. I'm going for more of a graphic feel versus a realistic feel for this airbrush project. So you can be as detailed as you want. You can go in and make it as accurate as you want. It's all up to you as the artist. My proportion may not be 100% spot on this pair of shoes, but it should look good in the end. I will tell you that up until this point, I had never painted a pair of shoes before. This was my first. I was a bit of a shoe virgin, if you will. But you can see I'm doing the exact same thing on the actual shoe as I did on the paper. I'm just sketching out the design, trying to replicate what I see in the reference image. And if you prefer that traditional method that you'll see in the books where you draw the center line on the face itself, use it. There's a million ways to skin a cat. As in everything else that I've showed you guys on my channel, I'm showing you a way. That doesn't necessarily mean that it is the way. You can do whatever works best for you. You can see I'm checking the proportion now, and the size of Iron Man's head actually looks pretty good at this point. So we will continue on. One thing I did notice here is this pencil did not want to transfer onto the shoe all that well, which is not necessarily a bad thing because I don't want heavy dark lines that I'll have to cover with paint. But I might have to explore other options for sketching designs when it comes to shoes. Once again, coming in to check proportion. I'm checking the eyes, and you can see the eyes are high once again. So I need to bring those back down. And the Helix electric eraser worked really well for erasing my mistake. moving the eyes down actually worked out well too, because it allowed me to bring that eye on the right side below the hole in the shoe. When I initially sketched that out, I thought, man, that's going to be kind of a pain to try and paint that around that little hole. And you can pretty much use any ruler for this purpose. I like these clear plastic rulers simply because you can see through them and they're very flexible. So this surface is obviously not perfectly flat like what I work on a lot of the time. So the flexibility in the ruler helps a lot. You may notice that I'm not getting extremely detailed here either. I'm just putting some rough guidelines in, kind of the roadmap that I talk about in so many other videos. You can add as much detail as you want, as much detail as you need. This is how I do it. Again, there's a million ways to skin a cat. Use what works for you. Coming back in with the ruler to check the proportion on that shoulder armor. And actually, rather than checking, I actually used the ruler to measure out how long that needed to be. I eyeballed it and then finished the line out after I put the ruler up on the shoe. And that's really all there is to it. It's a very simple method you can use to make sure that the proportion in your sketch or your drawing is correct. I have another method I use that is very simple. When I have a reference image that is a different size compared to the actual painting or the drawing that I'm working on, that we will cover in another video down the road. Before I close this one out, I just want to say that you should never underestimate the power of giving your own artwork as a gift. It is the holiday season, and receiving a piece of art from somebody else as a gift, regardless of your skill level, is something very special in my opinion. It's something that is far better than going out and just buying a gift for somebody in most cases, because you're putting time out of your busy schedule into that. You're putting your heart, your soul, your thought into that piece of art. And getting something like that from somebody is really something pretty special. I can't tell you guys how much I thank you for watching these videos. I hope you are learning something from the content on this channel. Painting is therapeutic for me. Teaching is also very therapeutic for me. I didn't realize how much I missed making these videos while I was away until I started it back up again. So I'm very glad to be back. Thank you guys so much for being a part of this channel, being a part of Wicked Art Studio. I appreciate you guys very much. Without you, I'm just a guy standing here talking to myself on camera. As always, I'll leave links in the description below to the products that I used in this video. It's just the ruler and the Helix electric eraser. Don't forget to check out the merchandise down below if you are so inclined. All of that goes to support the channel, and I appreciate that very much. Happy holidays. As always, I'm Trevor with Wicked Art Studio. I'll see you guys next week.